prolong the time, as you all know, I'm Dr. Demarcus Marshall, Vice Chairman of Allen County Board of Commissioners. I have the honor of serving you through all of these next couple months as the Vice Chairman. I'm honored to have with us also Ms. Joseph Evans, my colleague, if you will, your hand. I would also like to give all the city council a hand as well, because they chose to get all of this together. I think some of the other officials have kind of touched on it, but at the end of the day, when we vote on matters at the local government level, we don't say this is a Democrat issue or this is a Republican issue. This is property tax, okay? This is a noise ordinance. This is real stuff, okay? You'll never hear of the federal government or the state raising your property tax. So I'll just give you some stuff to think about. We talk about real issues. The budget, we went at it. Got the best that we could out of it. I tried to make a motion for clarification, as you all know. It didn't pass, mainly because we just had difference of opinions. And at the end of the day, the communication wasn't there, which should be a learning experience for some of you all running for office. You're not allowed. It takes more than you. I can't just stand up there and say, this is what's going to happen, right? So I take the fight. Fight another day, right? Hey, that's tomorrow. You fight up, run away, you'll fight another day, right?
Word.
Couple corners, community centers we're working on. But I'm at the point now, I'm ready to see more of our civic community issues addressed, such as giving our youth something to do. Also reducing our jail population. You don't hear much talk about that, but the fact is, I don't see jail as a business. I see jail really as a rehabilitative process in which it was supposed to be in the beginning. As y'all know, the jail is in the county, if you want the jail. So I'm kind of willing to deal and trying to help make that happen. Another thing to think about, I mean, you're going to be considering issues like development in the county in some parts of the city. We do wrestle with this thing called MAZ. You all start to hear it in the news now, right? It kind of prevents us from some of the development that some of us want to see. Why? Because it's a military activity zone. That's what keeps moving as a viable resource to the Air Force into our community. That's what keeps moving here. See, if we don't have some of those ordinances in place or restrictions in place, well, we jeopardize moving leave. And that's roughly a $450 billion economic impact to this region. So a lot of times, you know, there are other things going on. You know, it's not that we don't want to make things happen, but we kind of have to look at a big picture at the end of the day. You know, because say like the transportation field that we're talking about, I'm totally for it. But I've come to the realization it's going to take money to do, right? Well, I know we might not get the support to raise taxes to do it. But at the end of the day, I've kind of come to that realization that it might take that. I sat down and been honest with myself. Why? Because I realized this new transportation bill that did pass. Say when we do get to put a tax in place as a local municipality, it's not until 2017. And 30% of that goes to the state. So you don't hear about the details, right? I would go further to say that not only did the city pass a hotel increase last year, the county passed one this year, right? But the state plan adds $5 per person per night in the hotels, in every hotel in the state of Georgia. So do we really think we're going to be able to touch the hotel? I think we're going to have a fight with that real soon. There's a lot of things that we got to kind of look at now, because it ain't free. I've come up with my mind and say, hey, if it's going to take more money, I'll vote to pay more money. But everybody ain't going to do that. That's just being frank and honest with you all. The mayor spoke about House Bill 49, duplication of service. That was a heated battle years ago. I'm going to try to make it as easy as possible. Because the way I see it, everybody in the county pays taxes. It's everybody's money. If there's a way to reduce the taxes, tax burden for the citizens, I'm not going to sit in the argument. Somebody's got to be the donor in the room. So you won't see it in the flat for me. I'd be like, let's do it. And lastly, I just want to encourage candidates to get out there now, because you do know The Republicans are not happy about some of the decisions made this year, right? If you thought we've never had a battle or did battle with a Republican machine, it's coming in 2016. So all I'm going to say is, start getting out there now. Don't waste time. Whether it be municipal elections this year or next year, because they mad. They really, really mad. I mean, you've been talking about issues with the flag. You're talking about the same-sex marriage. You're talking about a lot of issues that have them energized, be honest. And so we got to be honest with ourselves. You got to get folks out to vote. Playing and waiting till the last second ain't going to do it. It just ain't going to do it. You're asking for, you're really asking for a loss. And I guess the last thing I want to add to my comment was about a person that's coming out now. You know, when I chose to run for office, I only told two people, my wife and this lady right here, Laverne. And it came to my knowledge this evening that she'll be leaving us. I don't know if she told me. And that really, really, really cuts me. Why? I mean, because it was at her house, at the Democratic Party's meeting, we were having to watch the State of the Union address, where I was sitting right beside my opponent. And I didn't know he was my opponent at the time, but I hadn't even decided to run. The fact is, he was talking about what he wanted to do for the county and this and that there and all. And then I later found out that he had switched parties. He was a Democrat, but he switched to be a Republican because he thought he'd get more votes. Long story short, I had him raised a week prior to qualifying. And here I am today. I just want to say thank you, Laverne. You're really immense, and I hope that you do just as much work for the Democratic Party and Augusta as well.
Amen.